All right, this is John Cole with Growing Your Greens with the update on the tree kale. So the tree kale is actually falling over, and we had to actually restake. I think I originally used 8-foot tall stakes. I'm sorry, 6-foot tall stakes, and they maybe went down to here, and they were just getting too big, and this tree kale was getting too large. Look, I mean, look at this big mass of greens on the top. Now, all these greens are edible. They taste like kale, and actually in the wintertime, when we're getting up to winter here, one day at a time, real close, these will get really sweet. And so we're trying to leave a lot of foliage on the tree, but we don't want them to get too tall, so they're getting kind of tall. So I bought basically 8-foot redwood stakes. We actually cut down from redwood 2x2 here, and so they basically are you know, two feet taller than the other stakes. And you got to keep your tree kales trained. You know, number one thing with tree kales, keep them trained, otherwise they will get all crazy. So look at this one. We weren't training for a little bit, and you'll get all these curves in the stem, or the trunk, if you want to call it a trunk. It's a nice diameter trunk here. There's my thumb. It's definitely thicker than my thumb here. So yeah, keep your tree kales trained. We're getting this tape here. This is like a nursery tape, so it doesn't cut off the circulation of the plant. The plant will just expand, and this will expand as well. And we were using these clips from Harbor Freight Tool for a little bit. They seem to work all right, but you know, the tree outgrew them fairly easily. So yeah, always train your tree kales, really important. And so the question is, where is a tree kale available? So this tree kale hasn't actually gone to seed for me, so I haven't gotten seed. So how you have to propagate this is by cuttings. So you could actually come up here, and we're gonna do this in another episode. You gotta take this, the new growing shoots, and you're gonna cut this off right here, and you know, and basically put them in some rooting hormone and start a new plant from the growing tips. And I actually purchased these at Arts and Ecology Center, which I may have mentioned before, and I don't think they do mail order, so you're gonna have to, it may be kind of hard to find, you know, tree kale starts. They're definitely one of my favorite kales. And so this is John Kohler with growingyourgreens.com, and remember, you can grow your own greens.